Hello, everyone. Pastor Jeremiah here. And I just want to say thank you for tuning in today. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. And today is Faith Friday. And just trying to give you a little bit of just something to remember these days by, because sometimes you can get in the middle of a day, things aren't going too swell, or, you know, it just hasn't been that good of a day. And you can remember, hold on one second. We've already declared this is Faith Friday, so I'm going to have the faith to believe that something good's coming out of this day. Something good's about to turn around for me. Something good is going to happen no matter what I'm seeing, no matter what I'm experiencing. I choose to believe that God has something good in store for me because He is a good God. So I want to say thank you for watching today. I appreciate it. We've been in this series all week long on biblically responding to spiritual attacks, And the Lord has just given us some prophetic words and some words of wisdom and prophetic words and just things like that during this week, because I truly believe it's one of the reasons for that is because the Holy Spirit knows that many of you that are watching, he knows what you're in need of. He knows where you're at. He knows the season you're in. He knows what you're coming up against. And for some of you, the Holy Spirit knows you are in an attack right now, a severe attack. And the Holy Spirit is speaking victory over you. The Holy Spirit is singing victory over you, shouting victory over you, because you're going to walk in the overflow this year. This is the year of overflow, 2018, and we're just going to see the Lord do some mighty things. And so thank you so much. I do want to let you know that we will not have a devotional on Saturday or Sunday. So we're doing Monday through Friday right now. And so if you want to pick up Saturday morning and just watch one of the ones that you've already watched this week, that would be good for you. You can't get enough of the Bible, can't get enough of teaching, can't get enough of Spirit-filled teaching. And so do that, but we will not be doing a devotional Saturday or Sunday. We'll pick back up Monday, okay? So we are in Nehemiah chapter 4. Nehemiah chapter 4, and I stopped yesterday at verse 19. And the response number 8 was this: do not get isolated. Don't allow hell to isolate you and therefore seek and be able to destroy you. Beloved, there is strength in our numbers. There's strength in our numbers. You're part of a body. You're part of the church of Jesus Christ. And the Bible says that He will build His church and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And so when you're part of the church, You know you have a promise that Jesus is going to build you. And so we left off in verse 19. We're going to pick up in verse 20 today. And I just want you to hear what the Word of God says right here. Wherever you hear the sound of the trumpet, rally to us there. Our God will fight for us. Now, this is not one of my responses, but I just want to pause for a minute, because especially in the times when you're experiencing attacks, do not give into the temptation. Do not give into the temptation to rely upon your own strength, to rely upon your own wisdom, to rely upon your own understanding. The Bible says, lean not upon your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct your paths. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. And so you don't give in to the temptation to try to fight on your own, fight in your own strength, fight with your own wisdom, try to fight in the flesh. Don't give in to that kind of temptation to try to go and fight in the way of the world. That is not where your battle is. The Bible says that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God. They're mighty through God for the pulling down of strongholds. And so that's where our weapons are. And so you must understand that when you try to step out in your own strength, your own wisdom, or you try to step out in the flesh and you try to fight a spiritual attack, that is just like sending soldiers to the battlefield with water guns in their hands. That you've got the wrong fight. You're not going to win. It don't matter what the gun looks like. It cannot bring victory to those soldiers. And so you got to make sure that you keep this in your mind. My God will fight for me. I just need to stay in the Spirit. I need to stay linked up with the Lord. I need to stay in the fellowship of the Spirit. I need to keep my faith. And I just need to keep worshiping Him and blessing Him and having faith. This is Faith Friday. And our God will fight for us. Our God will fight for us. The battle is not yours. It is the Lord's. And so I just wanted to stop for a minute and just because that is verse 20 is way too good just to skip over it. So we're going to verse 21. So we labored in the work, and half of the men held the spears from daybreak until the stars appeared. Now, I want you to think about that. From daybreak, that means, from the sun, just when you could barely see, to when the stars appeared, they were there. So biblical response number nine, be willing to work hard and fight long. Listen, there are some seasons where you've got to put it in. There are some seasons for those of you that are watching that has ever started a business. You know what I'm talking about, especially being a godly business owner where you've made it your aim to tithe. You've made it your aim to sow seed. You've made it your aim to help to sow as much as you can into the kingdom of God. I want you to know something. As soon as you make that your aim and you begin, then the attacks begin to come. And there's one thing you got to do. You got to work hard. You got to put your hand to something and you cannot quit. And you got to be willing to fight long. And I'm telling you, God will show up. God will show up at your best. When you're doing your best, God will do the rest. Remember that. When you're doing your best, God will do the rest. He wants your best. And there's some people, listen, there's some of us that we're losing in the battle, not because we don't serve a big enough God, not because you don't have the knowledge, not because you don't have the wisdom, not because you don't have the want to. Just some of us aren't willing to work hard and fight long. And there's just some things, church, that you got to put your hands in. There's just some things you've got to get to it. And I'm not trying to say you do the work of God or what I mean by that, you do God's work for Him. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying you do what you can and God will do what you can't. Okay. You do what you can and God will do what you can't. But there's response number nine. So when you're experiencing a spiritual attack, be willing to fight long. You know, get hard-headed about the right things. Some of us are hard-headed about the wrong things. We're hard-headed against the Lord. We're hard-headed against the church. We're hard-headed against the Word of God. I mean, it's like the Holy Spirit has to get a hammer and chisel stuff into our minds on a regular basis. You know what? Why don't you take that hard-headedness and turn it towards the right thing? Get hard-headed, but get hard-headed against hell. Get hard-headed against the spiritual attacks. Get hard-headed against the wickedness of this world. Turn around and dig your heels in and get hard-headed and say, no matter what, I will not leave my post. I will not be moved. I will stick this thing out. God will give me the victory. And I'm just hard-headed enough to sit here and until it happens. Work hard. Be willing to work hard. Be willing to fight long. Ministers out there starting churches, pastors taking over new places. Be willing to work hard and be willing to fight long. Because I'm telling you, when the Lord sees your best, He's going to do the rest. He'll show up for you. So let's move on because we're to response number 10. Now watch this at verse 22. And at the same time, I also said to the people, let each man and his servant stay at night in Jerusalem, that they may be our guard by night and a working party by day. So neither I, my brethren, my servants, nor the men of the guard who followed me took off our clothes, except that everyone took them off for washing. Now, I almost made response number 10. I almost called it keep your clothes on, but I didn't do that. So this is what we're going to call it right here. And this is going to register to you. Response number 10, keep a spirit of ready. Keep a spirit of ready. One of the strategies and the tactics of the enemy is to rock you asleep. It's just he doesn't do it real fast. I mean, you got to realize that I don't know where he gets it, because I don't call it patience, because patience is a fruit of the spirit. And I know Satan does not have any fruit of the spirit. But let me just say this. He's willing to wait for a long time. He's willing to be subtle about things. He's willing to ease and do things in a very minute way, because he's looking at a big goal. And the big goal is to kill, steal, and destroy you. That is the big goal. And so when you don't have a spirit of ready, when you're not armed, equipped, clothed with a spirit of ready, it is easy to just start getting into a routine of lukewarm living, of complacency, of apathy. It is easy to get into a lifestyle of lethargy, to where nothing's rattling you no more, you know, and you don't, I keep saying this because I see it so much, but your church attendance is hurting from it. You don't really have the desire to attend church anymore. You know, once you attend every Sunday, every time doors was open, you was in prayer meetings, you was doing all you can, and now you're barely able to make it twice a month. And then all of a sudden your prayer life is suffering. Now you find your prayer life, even when you do pray, you find it just being dry. It's just the same old words over and over again. And basically you're doing it to check a box. And when you do open your Bible, it's just to get a couple verses in. That's about it. Let me tell you something. That's not the spirit of ready. The spirit of ready is having a spirit that's alert, is vigilant. It is ready, on guard at all times, because you realize that listen, God may call on you to do something at any time, or hell might want to try to attack at any time, and you've got to be ready. Just think about it this way. Maybe this will help us to put it in perspective. What if there was times where our military, the United States of America has an amazing military, the best in the world, the greatest in the world. We have men and women all over the world right now that are putting their life in harm's way, leaving their families so that we can have freedom. And we're so grateful for that. We appreciate that so much. But just think about this. What if there was seasons, times, months in our military where they said, you know what? Let's just take it easy, guys. Let's just take it easy for the next 5 months. Let's don't worry about being ready. Now, if something happens, we'll try to get everybody together at that time, but let's just don't worry about being ready. What do you think would happen? The enemy sooner or later is going to figure out that we're not ready, and we're going to get blindsided. Or like we used to say in the streets, you're going to get sucker punched. And it's hard to recuperate from a sucker punch. It's hard to stand back up from being blindsided. I'm not saying it's impossible. It's just tough to. It's a lot tougher to do that than to just stay ready and see it coming before it ever hits you. And so what I'm trying to say today is, church, response number 10, let's keep a spirit of ready. Let's stay. Jesus said this. He said, if they would have known when the master of the house was coming, they would have been ready. They wouldn't have slept, and they wouldn't have slumbered, and they wouldn't have been drunk. He said, but they didn't know. Why? Because Jesus is coming as a thief in the night. And what I'm trying to tell you is that the other side of that spectrum is, not only are we waiting and being about the Father's business because Jesus is coming, but we are also have a spirit of ready, because we understand that the enemy of our souls hates us and wants to try to attack us and wants to try to take us out, wants to try to kill our marriages and destroy what God has built in our lives and destroy ministries and try to come against our kids. But let me just tell you this. I don't say all that to put fear in you, because the Bible says this right here, that God has not given you a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. I'm not trying to put fear in you. What I'm trying to tell you is that when you're ready and when you have a spirit of ready and you're prayerful and you're watchful, the Bible says that when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of God will lift the standard against him. And so when you've got that spirit of ready, you're full of the Spirit, you're prayed up, you're watched up. And so when the enemy tries to come in, the Holy Ghost said, no, I've got this right here. He lifts the standard higher than what the enemy can reach. And therefore, the Bible says that those who dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And therefore, when you're lifted above him, then what he's shooting at you can't hit you, because you're kept with a spirit of ready. Peter said this the best. And what better person to let us know about this than the Apostle Peter? Because now think about this. Peter, in the time when he thought he was the strongest, in the time when he thought that we'll just say it like this. He told Jesus, he said, let me paraphrase, it don't matter what you say, I'll die with you, Lord. And Jesus says, Peter, let me tell you something. An attack is about to come your way so hard that before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times. Now, this is the same Apostle Peter that writes this under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit later. This is what he writes. Therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Resist him steadfast in the faith. Today's Faith Friday. Knowing that the same sufferings are experienced by your brotherhood in the world. But may the God of all grace, who called us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while, perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. Peter knew what that was about right there. Peter said, you know what? I know what it's like to suffer a while, but praise God. Now I know to have a spirit of ready. Now I know to be sober, to be vigilant, and to be watchful, and to be prayerful. Now I know this, because I won't let hell sucker punch me again. Listen, keep a spirit of ready. Ask the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, quicken me. Quicken my mind. Quicken my heart. Quicken my spirit. Quicken my soul. Quicken me to be on guard. Put the armor on. Clothe yourself with humility. Clothe yourself with the armor of light, as Romans says. Clothe yourself with the armor of God, as Ephesians says. And be ready. Keep a spirit of ready. And I'm telling you, if you'll do that, you will walk in the victory of Jesus Christ. You will be like the five wise virgins. The five wise virgins, they had oil in their lamp. And they were able to trim their lamps, and they were able to light those lamps when the bridegroom came. And I know that's talking about when Jesus comes back, but the underlining thing is having a spirit of ready. That's what it is. And so the Bible says that the groom chose the five wise virgins, not the five foolish virgins. So I want to pray for you today. Today's Faith Friday. I'm believing that God is doing something miraculous in your life. That God has taken the faith, even if it's just the size of a mustard seed, and he's moving the mountain on your behalf. I want to pray for you today and believe that the Lord is going to continue to move in such a way, and that the Holy Spirit is going to continue to stir a spirit of ready in you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for my dear brothers and sisters that are watching all over this world right now. And Father, today I ask in the name of Jesus that your Holy Spirit would help us to keep a spirit of ready. God, that we would not give in to lethargic living, lukewarm living, apathy, complacency. Father, I ask in Jesus' name, Lord, it is high time that some of us wake up, God. for the days are evil. We need to redeem the time. And so, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, let there be a stirring from the Holy Spirit right now within each and every one of us. And let us be quickened and awakened so that we can have a spirit of ready no matter what we face. And I decree and declare over my brothers and sisters today that all who are working and doing and walking in the will of God and Lord that are serving you, I decree victory over their lives in every single way. Victory over your children. Victory over your finances. Victory over your marriages. Victory over your walk with Christ. Victory over your churches. Victory over your ministries. By the power of the Holy Spirit, I decree and declare it. In the strong name of Jesus, amen. Listen, thank you once again for watching. And for those of you that are in the South Atlanta area and you're looking for a church that's on fire, you're looking for a church where God is moving. I don't know about you, but I don't want to go to a church just for a social event, just to be a part of a social club. I can go anywhere for that. When I go to church, I want to meet with God. When I go to church, I want to know that I'm in His presence and that corporate anointing. Wow, that's a powerful thing. If you're looking for a church that's not just in this religious rituals, but is seeking after God and the atmosphere is electric with His power and His anointing and His presence, and you're in the South Atlanta area or you're willing to make a drive and you're not in the South Atlanta area, I want to invite you out to Abundant Life Church right here. Abundant Life Church, Locust Grove, 751 Dean Patrick Road, Locust Grove, Georgia. We'd love to have you. Or you can just go on our website, abundantlifechurch.com. You can find out all the details. If you're in the North Macon area or the Macon area, Forsyth area, somewhere down there, check out our church campus, Abundant Life Campus down in Forsyth right there. And you can find that on the website as well. We love you. We care about you. And we're believing God's best for you. This Faith Friday, let your faith be stirred. And I'm telling you, when your faith touches His power, all things are possible. We'll see you Monday. God bless.
Thank you for tuning in to the Abundant Life Devotional Series. These devotionals are available across many platforms, including Facebook, the Abundant Life Revival Network YouTube channel, and the Abundant Life app. If you are in the South Atlanta or North Macon, Forsyth areas, we would love to have you visit one of our campuses. For locations or more information about Abundant Life Church, please visit us at abundantlifechurch.com. Remember, this is your season to overflow.